Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 13.3.1 Developer Beta 3 and Public Beta 3 have been out for a few days. I've been using it primarily on my iPhone 11 Pro Max, along with my 2018 iPad Pro. Now, I do have it on a bunch of other devices, but based off the YouTube community poll, I've gathered a bunch of information for all of the different phones to let you know how it is on all of those. Now, I'll talk about the release date and everything else a little bit later, but if you want to jump to a specific part of the video, check the description where I have the time codes listed and you can just jump to what you'd like to see. Now, the first issue I've been having with iOS 13.3.1, where in general it's been pretty stable, but overall there are still a few little bugs in it. So I would say it's pretty nailed down and ready to go, but there's a weird little issue with mail, for example. So if I go into mail, you'll see I have one new email and I have this little button turned on here. And what this does is allow me to see only the unread email. So if I push that and turn that on, I'll only see unread email. However, sometimes if this says I have 5 email and I go into email, I'll only see one until I turn it off and turn it back on again, or just leave it off. Then I'll see the email. Sometimes email doesn't come in as fast as I'd like either. And for some reason with iOS 13 and all of the subsequent updates, mail just still seems to have issues. So I'm not sure what this is all about, but there's definitely issues here and there. Now, as far as the iPhone, I haven't personally had any other issues with it except for that. But with the iPad, I've had quite a few issues on the iPad Pro. So one of the issues I've been having is touch responsiveness, specifically in the YouTube app. Sometimes I'll go in here, maybe I'll search for something, go to tap on what I want to watch, and it just won't work. And the only way to fix it is actually turn the screen off, turn it back on again, and then unlock it, and then it will work again. So I'm not sure what that's all about. I've seen this multiple times, and sometimes you even need to reboot the iPad. Along with the touch responsiveness issues, sometimes if I go into Safari, for example, and I want to type a URL, maybe I want to type Apple, and I'll go ahead and hit go. All of a sudden it will clear itself and not go to Apple or another website if I have different tabs open. So it's really hit or miss, but it's been strange overall. But other than that, I have to say that it is pretty stable overall. I really have not had any issues with it other than those couple things. So they can iron out those few little bugs prior to it actually coming out, and hopefully we'll see that resolved. And you should be reporting these if you're having issues like I have with connectivity in the past. You should report them with the Apple feedback app, and then Apple takes that information and prioritizes it based on the most important. So if maybe you didn't have LTE connectivity at all, you had no signal, they're going to put that at the top, where something like mail not being or not showing properly and having a workaround is going to be lower down on the actual list. So they do take that and prioritize it. Now, as far as the release date of iOS 13.3.1, well, I would expect it this week. In fact, I'd expect it Monday or Tuesday based on what they've been doing in the past, but it's really hard to say because I really thought they were going to release a final and instead they released beta 3. So we could see beta 4, but I'd be surprised if we don't see the final. Now, if we do see the final of iOS 13.3.1, I would expect iOS 13.4 beta 1 the following day or next few days or even the following week. Usually they do it the same week, but Apple's been changing some things up for a while, and it's hard to say exactly what they're going to do. But with iOS 13.4 betas, I would expect some new features or at least some minor features until we get to iOS 14 releases and those betas in June. So it's hard to say what Apple's doing for sure, but we may have an event in March. We're not really sure at this point, but that's it as far as their update cycle. Hopefully we'll see this finally released this coming week. Now, before I talk about battery, let's talk about performance. Now, performance for me has been really good. If I go into things like music, things play fast, things scroll quickly, I can go into anything I'd like, and I have no issues whatsoever. Everything is loading quickly. If I go into the control center, it's loading quickly, and I've had no issues with performance. Battery has been good overall as well, and according to you on the YouTube community poll, most of you say the same thing. So if we go into settings, and then we go down to battery, and you'll see the battery health on this phone is 100%. And just so you can see this a little bit better, let me flip on the light mode, and you'll see that over the last 10 days, Well, yesterday I only had 2 hours and 56 minutes of screen on time with about 45% battery life used. So, in general, it's pretty good for me. Usually I'm getting 10 to 12 hours, but it just depends what I'm doing, whether or not I'm on Wi-Fi or LTE, and that really affects the experience overall. So, depending on what I'm doing, whether or not I'm on dark mode at night, things like that will affect some of the battery life, with the black being turned off when you're in settings, for example. It's not actually lighting up these pixels. So all these little things help, and all those little tweaks help, but battery life in general, I can't complain. The same is true on the iPad as well, so I thought I'd show you that since I have it here. This one is down to 11% battery right now, and if we go down to battery, let's see what it's like. I have not checked this, so I'm not sure what it's like. So you'll see I only use 2 hours and 9 minutes of screen on time. So 2 hours and 9 minutes of screen on time with about 25% of the battery used. So that means if you multiply 25% times four, if that's 100% of the battery, then I'm getting about 12 hours of screen on time with the iPad Pro, which I expect 10 to 11, so that's pretty good. And I have no complaints. I normally use this just for YouTube and things like that, doing email and Safari and things. Now, as far as battery life for all of you on all of the different devices, almost all of you said you had good battery life. Now, there were a few that said you didn't out of all of the 100 or plus comments that were listed on the community poll, but quite a few of you said it was quite good or the same as Beta 2, which is better than iOS 13.3. So expect it just to be better overall. And unless you have maybe an iPhone 7, some of the iPhone 7s in particular, for some reason, seem to be having some weird performance issues, LTE issues, not connecting, and things like that. But in general, it's been pretty good going back to the iPhone SE 6 or 6S and 6S Plus. Now, some people were saying with the going into Control Center, it was stuttering. Usually, the people with home button phones for some reason. And then a couple people were saying the phone was getting hot or locking up and having to reboot it to actually clear that issue with it being overheated. So it's not really overheating. It will tell you that it's overheating, but it feels hot in your hand. And if you're not doing any intensive tasks like playing games or anything, that may be a bit of a concern. So you may want to reboot it at that point. And then finally, as far as things you had to say, CarPlay still seems not to be so great, even on 13.3.1. I know they revamped CarPlay with 13, and for some reason, it just hasn't been great since iOS 12. So it's still going to be a little bit buggy, give you a few issues, unfortunately, and that's just the way it is. Now, for those of you that like stats, here on the left are some of the issues mentioned. Now, there's 39 people that mentioned battery. Like I said, most of those are pretty positive, but some of them are not. But most are. Five people mentioned RAM management, and most said it was good or decent. A couple people said it wasn't great, but most of you liked it. Four people mentioned mail, and there's the rest. Now, here's the devices you're using as well on the left. So, if you want to take a look at that, these are all the devices mentioned in the comments as well. Now, as far as the YouTube community poll is concerned, at this point there are 8.6K votes, so 8,600 or 8,600 votes. We just hit low battery on the iPad Pro there, so I'll plug it in a moment. But we had 8,600 votes or so, and 14% of you said that it was great. Only 3% said terrible. I believe that was the same on the previous beta. 5% said okay, but some bugs, which is actually lower than before. And you can see that if you just scroll down here a little bit. 6% said okay, but some bugs before. So it's a little bit better. 63% of you are on the public version of iOS 13.3 or an older public version, and 15% of you are on Android. Now, 112 of you commented, and I've gone through every one of your comments to talk about what I just talked about with issues that were mentioned. But let's take a look at some of them just so you can take a look. And you can also go to the community poll and take a look itself or look for yourself as well. So it says, "I'm sure it's fine. It's okay. A family member using an iPhone 7 has lost all cellular connectivity on Verizon. We reset it and restored it in recovery mode, and it still didn't fix it. iOS 13.3 gives an error, unable to update cellular connectivity. At this point, you may want to talk to Verizon, try a different SIM card or something like that. I have heard this a few different times with iPhone 7s for some reason, so hopefully it's fixable with an update, but 13.3 should not be having the issue. I really love the battery of iOS 13. 14.3.1. I still have swipe up stutter issues with Control Center. It's so annoying when I want to quickly turn on or off something. Already reported multiple times, but I start to worry that maybe my device is affected. Otherwise, everything runs smooth, iPhone SE. And they're on beta 3. So again, like I mentioned, you're not the first person to mention that. I would expect it to be fixed, but they're going to fix things like LTE first and then come to something like a stutter, for example. LTE is a lot better from beta 2. Battery life is the same, iPhone 7. iPhone 10 seems good thus far all the way around. iPhone XR, so far everything is great. Battery life may be a little bit better. So far so good on the XS Max. Setting up Siri keeps popping up whenever I reboot my phone. The way for setting up Siri is glitchy and doesn't look right. Connectivity has improved for sure with the modem update along with battery and speed. No bugs till now, and this looks like the GM version. Screen time issue solved. Overall, a good update for the 11 Pro. I return to the standard release because it's stable. 13.3.1 Beta 2 and 1 have problems with opening Control Center on iPhone 7. I haven't heard a whole lot of people say that iOS 13.3 is stable. In fact, most people say it's very buggy. It's been good so far with only one incident where the phone froze up while closing out a background app. Had to force the phone into a reboot and all was fine after. No other incidents or freeze-ups after. iPhone 11 Pro. Pro Max and 2018 iPad Pro. Feels like a stable GM. 3 hours of screen on time with 60% left. Off the charger for 13 hours. Only occasional bugs that still persist on the iPad is opening an iMessage and having no keyboard sometimes. Running smoothly on my 8 Plus, has a frame rate drop every blue moon, battery life seems okay. On my 11 Pro Max, basically the same thing, having a weird bug where the slam effect in iMessage locks up the phone until it's finished. Using an iPhone 11 with no issues at all. Great, I'm still using an iPhone 6S Plus. I'm using an iPhone 8 Plus, 128GB, works good. iPhone XR, I feel it is the same as iOS 13.3 and beta 1 and 2 of 13.3.1. iPhone XR, battery life is decent, haven't found any bugs, seems smooth. So that's it for iOS 13.3.1 Beta 3. Now, I wouldn't really expect any new features until iOS 13.4 comes out with a beta and then a final release, but don't expect iOS 13.4 to come out until we see the final release of 13.3.1, and then we'll start to see those betas of iOS 13.4 with hopefully some new features as well. So that's really it for the small update of 13.3.1. Let me know if you found anything else in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.